وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters who are listening to me, inshallah ta'ala, I want to share this important message with each and every one of you. This message is about the concept of التحزب المذموم, to have fanaticism for a particular individual, to the extent that if this individual says to you that this is where you could go, you go. And if they say to you, you can't go here, you don't go. And this haqiqatan, it goes against the methodology and the way of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. وَلِذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ إِبْنُ تَيْمِيَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ mentions in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, he says, وَلَيْسَ لِلْمُعَلِّمِينَ أَن يُحَزِّبُ النَّاسَ. It is not befitting, it is not permissible, it is not allowed for the teachers, أَن يُحَزِّبُ النَّاسَ, that they divide the people and they break them into groups. وَيَفْعَلُ مَا يُلْقِي بَيْنَهُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ, and they place in the hearts of the people hate and enmity. So the teacher will say to his student, for instance, don't go to that particular teacher. And the reason why he would say that is because he has a personal issue with that teacher. He doesn't personally like that teacher. So he forces his students and those who take knowledge from him not to go to that particular person because of the grudge and because of the personal inclination that he has. He bans his students from going to benefit from that person. And this Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, it is not correct. وَلَيْسَ لِلْمُعَلِّمِينَ أَن يُحَزِّبُ النَّاسَ. It is not right for the teacher to do this. And nor should he go that direction. And then Ibn Taymiyyah went on carrying on to say, بَلْ يَكُونُونَ مِثْلَ الْإِخْوَةِ الْمُتَعَاوِنِينَ عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, aid one another in good and righteousness and piety. Don't aid one another in al-ithm wal-udwan. Don't aid one another in that which is sinful and that which goes against obedience and righteousness. Dividing the students and dividing the people is at-ta'awanu al-ithm wal-udwan. And then Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, be conscious of Allah and fear Him, O teachers. إن الله شديد العقاب. Allah تبارك وتعالى, His punishment are very severe. I want to mention a story here, inshallah ta'ala. This story is regarding a great scholar, a scholar that lived in this time that we're living. He's none other than Al-Allama Al-Muhaddith Muhammad Nasiruddin Al-Albani. Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin Al-Albani, two people came to him one day and they had a conflict. And these two people who came to him, both of them were mashayikh, people of knowledge. The first one is Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i. And the second one is Muhammad Nasir al-Tirmanini. Rahimahumullah, may Allah have mercy upon each and every one of them. Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i and Muhammad Nasir al-Tirmanini, when they both came to him, Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah, he listened to the khilaf, the dispute that was present between the two sheikhs. Sheikh Al-Albani was listening. He listened to the khilaf, the dispute between Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i and Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Tirmanini. He listened. And Sheikh Al-Albani, after listening, he came to the conclusion rahimahullah, that the haq and the truth is on the side of Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Tirmanini, that the truth is with him, and that Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i is in the wrong. When Sheikh Al-Albani spoke to Muhammad, Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i, to tell him that he's wrong and that his position in this issue is to come back and to ask forgiveness from his brother, Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i refused. And when he refused, Sheikh Al-Albani became angry with Sheikh Muhammad Nasib Al-Rifa'i. And Sheikh Al-Albani took the side of Sheikh Muhammad Nasir Al-Tirmanini. And Sheikh Al-Albani boycotted Sheikh Muhammad Nasib Al-Rifa'i. Sheikh Al-Albani boycotted him, keeping in mind that Sheikh Muhammad Nasib Al-Rifa'i is a man of knowledge. And they say that he was the muassis, the one who established Jam'iyyat al-Da'wah al-Salafiyyah. So Sheikh Al-Albani, what he did was, when he realized that Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i does not want to take the truth, and he does not want to follow the truth, Sheikh Al-Albani boycotted him. But the moral of the story is this. This is the moral of the story. And that is, Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i, when Al-Albani boycotted him, he didn't tell his students to do that. And he did not force his students to follow him in this view. Rather, his students, they would go to Sheikh Muhammad Nasib al-Rifa'i and they would take knowledge from him. And they would benefit from him. And they would converse with him. And they would even have dialogues regarding their affairs. Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah, Sheikh Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, never forced his students to follow him in his view. And this teaches us something, that the scholars were never ones to do tahzeebun nas, to divide the people, and to teach the students to be fanatic towards them, and to have fanaticism towards them. They were far from that. They believed that the people, if they're going to stick to something, and if they're going to hold on to something, it has to be the kitab and the sunnah, and also bima alihi salafu salih, that which the pious predecessors were upon. So let that be, inshallah ta'ala, something that we implement in our lives, as teachers especially. And also, if you have a group of people who listen to you, don't be a person who does tahzeebun nas, divides the people because of your personal issues with a particular person. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.